High intensity interval training, or HIIT for short, is all the rage these days. HIIT are workouts that combine aerobic training and strength training all in one, allowing people to save time. Everybody is just so busy these days that it's no wonder why HIIT is all the rage these days. Of course, the team at Down Dog had to throw their hat in the HIIT ring by releasing their own app. Titled Down Dog HIIT, it is part of the suite of Down Dog apps that I've been reviewing. Watch my other videos in that series as well. Is this app as good as their other offerings, or should you go hit up another app? Does an obese man like me burn a lot of calories doing HIIT-based training with this app? Let's see with this review of Down Dog HIIT. Again, sorry about the light shadow here. If you watch my previous videos, yes, I'm still recording it the same day.
For self-improvement, crafts, and fitness games, go ahead and turn on YouTube and watch Jack.
First, let's get started with an overview of the app. You can always skip around in the chapters below to find the interesting part that you came here to watch. Down Dog HIIT, just like their other apps, is an auto-generative tool set. The app will create a workout based on the settings that you choose from. This auto-generative nature allows for a ton of different combinations, ensuring a unique workout pretty much every single day. The app is available for purchase along with the rest of the Down Dog suite of applications for just $60 a year, or $10 a month if you want to go monthly, but that $60 a year, that's a good price. That yearly price, like I said, is really not that bad, with it being $20 cheaper than Apple Fitness for us iPhone users. Apple Fitness is probably the closest app in comparison to Down Dog in popularity as far as the App Store is concerned. Seriously, though, with this having a 4.9 star rating across 50,000 ratings, Down Dog is amongst the most popular items that I am reviewing. That's just the App Store with this puppy. You also have the Android users who also love this app. I am still hoping for like a VR version of Down Dog HIIT, but you know, an obese man can dream.
Hips pressed high. Other side in 3, 2.
Once you log in with your Down Dog account, the HIIT app has just an insane amount of options that you can custom tailor the workouts to fit your needs. First, you have the circle control here that you can move to set how many minutes you want your workout to be. It goes from a brisk 4 minutes to 80 minutes of pure torture. Swiping up on the menu brings you to the settings for your practice, timing, and music. In practice, we have the mix option. This will be what you want your workout to be. Opening up, you can change the sliders around how much you want to work out to be focused on the different areas. Those areas include aerobic, legs, upper body, core, and of course, da booty, the glutes. There are also toggles if you want to include dumbbells, fitness bands, or a chair. There are tons of possible combinations, but if you don't want to just like mess around, you know, you want to just quickly go from one to the other, then you can choose a predefined mix. They got everything from total body shred to a day of plank hell to an ab-focused cardio workout. There are so many different possibilities, and I just love the variety in this option. I'll get to my specific time doing the workouts later, but I try to do a different one across each of the 30 days I was using this app, and I've never hit the same routine. They update the app nearly every other month, so I assume there'll be new workouts constantly thrown in. The developers do that thing though where like every time they update an app, they just throw bugs and other fixes. I'm like, great details. Once you choose your mix, you can choose your practice type. Either rotation, switch body parts over the course of the workout and repeats later, or progression. Hit one body part, then move on to the next from aerobic down to the glutes. From there, you can set up your upper body, lower body, and core level, which will increase or decrease the complexity of the workouts. You can change the speaker's voice and the model of the video. Modal. Lastly, you can change how much of the explanation you need for your workout. A setting that WeFit desperately needed. Check my review of WeFit down below. Below that, not below my description, but below that option, you can change the timing, which includes how long you want to warm up and cool down. As a side note, I've always kept this on auto and recommend you guys do the same. You need to prevent injury by making your body nice and limber enough to do the moves correctly. After those settings, you can adjust the interval and recovery period to fit your fitness skill. Obviously, I kept it at the same, but I increased the recovery length because I'm a big dude. Lastly, there is the music option, which allows you to pick your style. From basic pop to electro dance, there are a few good choices. There's no rock or rap, though, which is dumb because that's what I assume most people would work out to. No one's really working out to ambient guitar noises. No, we don't want to work out to goddamn AC/DC. All of these options explained above allows for way more customizability than traditional pre-recorded workouts. However, it does all this at the expense of losing some of the more personal feeling. Honestly, like I said in my review of Down Dog Meditation, I feel like the categories with a large difference, such as yoga and HIIT, do work better by having like a step-by-step course layout. That way you can kind of build your skill over the course of the period, rather than just kind of doing like a random workout here and there. This is also coming for someone who is a 300-pound man whose workouts were still a bit too much at level zero. I would want both paths as an automated generative workout, and I want courses. Basically, I want my cake and eat it too. Come on, Down Dog, provide me everything I want, all without raising the price.
Next, squat heel taps. Can't keep my hands to myself. 3, 2, 1, start.
After your workout, you can download it to your phone and use it in offline practice. There is also a calendar view that shows your practice score. You can set up weekly goals here as well. There is a history of all workouts if you want to repeat a specific day as well. I actually use this option a lot to kind of find the hot jams I wanted to add to like my workout playlists. Lastly, the settings, which is just the settings. You don't really care about that. Now let's get into my personal time on the Down Dog HIIT application. I usually try and do 60 days for my reviews, but instead decided to do 30 for the HIIT due to just different scheduling conflicts. Within these 30 days, I wanted to see at least some improvement in my cardiovascular health. I can say that I did definitely feel the burn, and I was sweating a lot with these workouts. Down Dog HIIT was just kicking my butt pretty regularly. Again, I am a nearly 300-pound man who works as a software developer. I don't have a lot of time dedicated to workout, which is kind of why I started this YouTube channel, just as a way to force me to work out more, do different fitness things, and just kind of experiment. So why don't you hit subscribe and watch me experiment more? Not like that, you know, I'm never going to start an OnlyFans account, but experiment just and try different things. The HIIT style is perfect for me, as I could squeeze a workout before I go upstairs to my home office. Also, I already had like bands and a dumbbell set, so everything I needed was all ready to go. All I needed to do was start the app. I like to go into depth with these reviews, so to cover all areas of the app, I wanted to do each mix at least once. There are like 20 different options, so it was definitely feasible. I set my workout time for a total of anywhere from 15 to 20 minutes per session, which is within the realm of my physical capabilities. I pretty much accomplished each of these two aspects, although I stayed far away from different mixes, like things like plank hell, because honestly, I know my limits. My shoulders could definitely not hold up my body weight for 15 minutes. Heck no. I did most of the workouts just fine, but I did have to quit a few of them just due to my weak core causing me cramps. There are times that I actually forgot to start my timer app before doing the warm-up, so some days may or may not count that when I calculated my calories. The app overall has kicked my butt, as you can see by how completely sweaty I got in my first day. First day doing HIIT, late in the evening. I'm very sweaty, in case you couldn't tell. It was pretty good. I burned 216 calories. Forgot to turn it off. In 20 minutes. So, it's a pretty good workout. Very sweaty. I did have to take quite a few breaks since it is, you know, mostly a cardio-based training. But hopefully, I can get my big gut here nice and strong so I can persevere throughout the entire 20 minutes. So I'll begin again tomorrow. With my personal review over, let's get to the statistics. I can't even say that word. Here are my detailed table of the workouts over the course of the 30 days. From this table, I gathered the statistics. Thanks, Excel. Hopefully I did the math right on these, because otherwise the internet's gonna make me look like an idiot. Over the course of the 30 days, I burned 4,136 calories. That gives me a total workout of 137 calories per workout per day. Total time spent with the app is 60 hours and 58 minutes. That is giving me an extra time per workout of 14 minutes and 25 seconds. That gives me a burn rate of calories per minute of 9.67, which is high. That does include like the slowdown and stretch periods, which of course my heart rate took some time to slow down. If I ignored those, the cool down and stretching, which takes 15% or 30% of the workout total, I would probably have a calorie burn rate of close to like 13 to up to 20 for like the cardio based workouts. I was sweating. Let me tell you, this is a good workout. In the past, I said that Down Dog is my favorite suite of applications, and Down Dog HIIT continues that trend. While there are some changes I wish I could be made, more or less it's the best fitness app in the App Store, and possibly even better than Apple Fitness. It's got both the Apple and Androids happy, and that's all really you can do. I know as an obese man, my fitness journey will pretty much never stop, so it's nice to know that there's quality to be found to help me in my journey. Sure, there are things I would like to have added to this app, such as a journey of different workouts that complete through a course to build up a particular skill. A calorie counter would be nice, and y'all need way more music options. Give me rap, give me rock, give me more metal. This app, despite those missing things, are still amongst my favorites of all time. Did you try Down Dog? Go ahead and leave a comment below letting me know if you liked it or not. I try to respond to each and every comment or posted. If you haven't tried Down Dog, then you can please leave me a suggestion on what to review next. This whole series I'm doing on Down Dog was actually started from a common thread that I referenced in my original first video. Continue that trend by leaving suggestions down below, and I will pretty much do them. I will do pretty much anything within the realm of self-improvement, you know, fitness, learning musical skills, learning really any skills, trying to improve relationships, all of that stuff. Subscribe to the YouTube channel and visit my website at jack-jenkins.com. Lastly, I want all you guys watching to have an incredible day. If you are wondering how we can improve, well, we can improve together.